Flying high over these barren Missouri river bottom fields, it's easy to see why area farmers' greatest challenge is often Mother Nature.
You know, we fight floods, it seems like, every other year.
The river can bleed over these banks as quickly as dryness has grasped these fertile soils. But when the weather cooperates, the bushels are bountiful.
Yields were phenomenal. We had record-breaking yields on almost every entity that we were harvesting last fall. So we had, you know, where I think 2014 was the last previously exceptional year, this was maybe even 20 to 30 bushel per acre better than what we were seeing those particular years in certain cases. So it was one of those years for the record books.
While the weather may be out of Woodward's control,
you have to plan for that.
Kaiser Family Farms plans for the unexpected each year while controlling what they can.
The acres that we farm are basically consolidated into one circle. Everything we farm is within 10 miles. So that makes it, from an efficiency standpoint, it makes it so much more enjoyable.
Woodward says they're looking at possibly purchasing a new planter for 2019 as their buys of new machinery have slowed.
We found other ways to look at upgrading our equipment. Instead of purchasing new, we've looked at a few used pieces. Typically, our operation buys new combines, new tractors, new planters.
Straggling purchases of both new and used iron is a trend local dealers like AgPower have adjusted to, but it's a trend that's starting to turn.
You know, the used equipment seems to be coming back. The last few years, we hit the lull, I felt like, and we started seeing it in harvest last year of the comeback of used equipment.
Plattner says farmers are opting to update older equipment, and the proof is in tractor values today.
It seems like the traditional farmer for us has decided to come in and start upgrading some older equipment. I don't know if you've seen it as you've been going around, but it seems like the older Ott series tractors or the older tractors are the ones that their value has just gone through the roof.
Machinery Pete has seen similar trends with used tractor values, with ones in the 5 to 20 year range boasting powerful prices.
On February 3rd, there were probably 8 auction prices that came in on tractors that were that 5 to 20 years old, and I would look at the price and look at this thing and go, well, this is the highest in 30 months or 40 months or 5 years. We're 5 years into this environment of more profit pressure, and we're at the point now folks are updating, and what they're looking for is the nicest used.
He says 1 or 2 year old machines are also seeing strong demand, and it's that momentum that caught Plattner by surprise.
I thought we were still maybe 12 months out, and they're coming back a little sooner than I thought.
But in this area of Missouri, planter purchases are even more impressive, with only one planter available on this lot today.
In our area, we run 1790 or 1795, 40-foot, 1631 row planters. Our customers really lean on one planter for corn and beans. It's a one machine. They don't have to invest in extra tires or anything on everything else. And so that's our number one selling planter. In our area, those are hot right now.
Machinery Pete says the interest in people wanting to buy planters started late last year.
A lot of interest in the late model ones. We started to see, particularly in December, auction pricing strong on 1, 2, 3 year old models at auction, if they were equipped right. And the search traffic data at machinerypete.com kind of exploded in December.
And he says that's continued into the first 6 weeks of the new year.
Yeah.
And as farmers like Woodward plan for planting in 2018, he strives to start off on the right foot.
At the beginning of the year, it all starts with what you put into those machines.
And it's all about the data.
We make sure when we start out the year, we're putting the correct data in every single machine. So when we go to the field, we have the right information there at the time, and we can start our process.
AgPower says they have a wide customer base, from farmers well-versed in technology like Woodward.
We are very technology-driven.
To ones just starting to latch on.
Where they're maybe not in the precision ag market, or they're very, very basic, very elementary steps in it, and they're kind of looking to see how can they drive that a little bit more, because they're a little bit capped at their acres. Maybe they're out there really trying to figure out how can I be more profitable across every acre across their operation.
Jason Reichert focuses on technology for the dealership. He says it's proper management of that data that can really pay off.
The thing in the data management world said for years is bad data in, bad data out. And so we have to have good information captured at the time of planting, at the time of spraying, at the time of harvest to be able to use that information.
AgPower has even started data days where they bring customers in to not only digest the data collected, but take a deep dive into what went right and what went wrong.
So at our data days last year, what we found most of it was inevitably a guy pulled in the field and named the field wrong, right? Or he didn't forget to change it when he went to the next one. So a lot of it was was just correcting operator error. That goes a long way.
Whether it be for the technology or because a tractor is too worn, equipment buys are picking up.
So if we can get through 2018 with decent yields, an okay price, I feel like we'll be back to our cycle.
And as Plattner peeks into the new year, he likes what he sees.
We feel like machinery sales are going to keep ticking up. I mean, I don't want to say that we're going to hit that bell curve and take off, but I do feel like planters and sprayer sales are really strong right now. I think it's going to take another harvest to clean up those combines that are still hanging behind. I really look for after harvest combines to pick back up, but we're pretty optimistic.
Optimism that's turning into an uptick for the equipment industry as a whole.
I think producers are looking for that extra edge and however they can get it. And if it's buying new, that's awesome. But if it's upgrading into used, they're leaning into that opportunity.
While prices and forecasts alter daily, Woodward remains upbeat.
I think as long as we can get the crop in the ground in a decent amount of time, you know, Mother Nature has to do her part, like we said earlier, but I'm optimistic as to where this is going for 2018.
A new year with a fresh start, as it's farmers like Woodward that know these winds of change are often what creates opportunity.